here. Up here. So I'm recording. That was a little scary.
Don't be afraid.
Oh, me?
Oh, me?
Thank you. I guess the slower the better. Look at all that clear cut. Go Bruins! Yeah, and that lake down there, probably very polluted as a result. And how they leave all this good wood just rotting. I forget the really stupid industry reason why they leave all this wood. It's some crazy bookkeeping or accounting thing. I forget the exact reason. It's stupidity in anybody else's book.
For sure. Man destruction.
Mm-hmm.
So sad to see when you see a lot of birds going away, moose running away from the machine, bears. Sometimes they cross over, they swim over, and they continue. They all continue all over. And they will never stop.
And a lot of hardwoods, a lot of birch being destroyed, and all they're planting is the crappy jack pine and the other softwood that grows fast. No diversity. But look at all these beautiful birch hardwoods. So I'm videotaping right now, and I'll upload this later. Just because we got no signal out here.
We get signal here when we go there, because we walk all the way over there.
Mm-hmm.
On top of that hill.
This will be higher quality, and I'll put this on YouTube as well.
I walk all over there, I went over there. Look at blueberry that. Picking at the same time, there's a lot of...
Would there still be blueberries now with all this clear cutting?
Well, there's still going to be blueberry, but I don't know about next year, because I don't trust those plantations there, because if you pick blueberry here and there's a plantation that goes to blueberry and there's none after.
And they spray a lot of the chemicals.
Yeah, and they get sick there. You get sick when you eat that chemicals, well, they spray. That's why I don't trust, like, here, but the old area, yeah, like where they're burning, been burned, that's where we usually go blueberry picking.
Well, they say they spray in the fall to, at this time, starting around, to kill all the hardwoods, so the pines grow quicker.
That's what they're doing, they're going to be spraying everything. After the plantation grows. So sad to see. That's what I don't like when I see it, when I drive around. All clear cut. It's not like before. Well, I never see this. It surprised me when I came. This about 3 years ago, where Louis got, there was just a little bit area that cutting. And after they took them to jail, I never came back here. And now they show us to, oh boy, they're really gone far away. They really cut a lot. Really a lot. It was like that when I saw it. Oh my God, look what they did. They all clear cut. It wasn't even like this. It was a bunch of trees. We only passed one road when we came, but here it wasn't like that. It was a lot of trees yet. We couldn't even see the lake here. But the lake we passed over.
Gorgeous lake.
Yes. So disgusting to see that. Even pay attention when they see it. No government never come this way to look at it. When they go around, oh, it's so nice. The nature is so nice, but it's not really looking at the nature.
Yeah.
When he's looking around, they see a dollar sign.
Mm-hmm.
Dollar sign on his eyes. That's what they're looking at. But nice nature? No. They don't see it that way. We see a lot of things here. We could have a good, the wind, a lot of things that's so sad to look at it. We came here, we talk about this. Bunch of Kokoms, we came here, we talk about it, we look at it. Oh my God, this is, where are we going to get our teaching and everything being destroyed? Three years time, they're going to be slashing.
And how far away from the highway so people don't see this?
Let's say about 25 miles from here. You go all the way over there. It could take you more places over there where the highway is. You can make a big round, come back, come out from Lac-Rella. Or go to Lac-Rella, all the way over, come out by La Roche. Go to Staggan Road.
Yeah, here in northern Quebec. And since this is a separate video, you want to remind everybody your name?
Lisa Thomas.
You're a Algonquin Kokom, a.k.a. grandmother.
I'm a Kokom.
And this is your territory? What's it called for people?
Yeah, this is the land of the people. This is where we share. I don't call it the trapping line. We all share this land together. The whole people used to hunt here. They camp in there. They used to paddle here, come in there. Long time ago, that's what the people used to do.
What's the name of this Algonquin territory?
Anishinaabeoki. This is Anishinaabe Anikiwin. Anikiwin. This is what you call it, territory. Anishinaabe Anikiwin. This is where they hunt. This is where they go hunt. This is how we say it in Indian, Anishinaabe Anikiwin. Anikiwin. My grandmother stayed here. We all shared. Everybody shared the land. We came here to do the trap for moose or beaver. Then they used to make tanda the moose, make our moccasin for us to use for the winter. This is what we do. So sad to see. We good. Well, I was telling her the way the lake we passed, the road there. We passed here, we could see the lake there. That's where it was.
Is that where the bridge was?
Yeah.
Or where they just paved the road and divided the lake in half?
Yeah. Where we passed, well, what is this, all the lake there? They cut all the near, almost near, too close to the lake. It was, I think, 200 feet there that can go to the lake. And some of them, they say 100 feet, but it's too close.
You want to walk over there where Shelley is? Get a view of the devastation in the valley. You can keep talking.
Well, we're looking at the A lot of old people come around there. My grandmother used to be here before I was born. And my mom shared me the story where she was. She's been paddling here all over. There's another lake over there. They go around. Little Poggin over there, the big Poggin River. That's what they used to stay a long time ago. Get their food, like fish. Sometimes they go for sturgeon. We kill sturgeon over in that big Poggin. It's so dangerous. Nobody can go there paddling because it's so. A lot of people got drowned there, they couldn't come up, never find their body. We talk about that. So this is it. Don't see nothing there no more. It's been all destroyed. It's so sad to see. And for people that, some people, they're flying in the area in the helicopter, checking for the mine. That's what they're doing. They're driving all over with the mine. So they know where they won't have that mining, so they came here. They dropped something. Dropped something in the bush so they know where they gonna go to the mining after. They just put the red spot so they can go there. That's what they're doing. Also seen the map. Nobody else ever seen it yet. It's one of our cousin, Anishinaabe, show us where they go, where they gonna go to the mining after. There's where they cut. That's what they do. They clear cut first. And if they find the mining, this is where they're going to come after.
Mountain top removal.
Yeah. It's a lot over there too, way back in Barrier. And where I was talking about.
Barrier Lake, yeah.
No, I mean Lac-Rela. You go way back over there, that's what they find the mining. They've been put all the red dots. That's where the mining is.
What kind of mining is happening at Barrier Lake? They're building a dam there, right?
Yeah, they built a dam there. And I don't know what kind of mining that's.
Because we're not that far from Barrier Lake here.
And that's where they're going to go next. After they cut their Lucy Lake, they're already making the another road over there to go and cut, because that's where they're going to have that mine. What their plan. I know all their plan. It's not all only for the look, the rocks. You see the rocks all over. They know there's a mine here. That's why they came here. Because they already flying around. About 6 years ago we seen them fire flying. They hit that big thing there and they drop it. Wherever they seen it, they make it a photograph, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So we've been following them, what they're doing. Well, actually, we see them. firefly and things of that thing. We didn't know first. And after we ask what they do, now they know they were checking the mine. So we know where they're going to have to mine after. Because if they do the mining, the water is going to be no good. The fish that we eat there is going to be all gone. And the trees are going to be all dead. It'll be just like a desert after. Nothing is going to be good after. All the animals are going to die. They don't see it, but we see it. Talk a lot about things like that. I hope people will understand what we're trying to talk about, to know what they're doing. You look at this area. They cut here in the winter time. They start a lot of animals got struck there. And yes, you could smell something a little bit over there. They all got squashed. They didn't walk all over to see it. Maybe down there, a lot of bear holes where they sleep all winter get squashed. Wolf and a lot of small animals that make their hole where to sleep, like the fox.
The dens, yeah.
Then porcupine is one of them that stays in the hole all winter. Skunk. Or they move. They say when they cut the only about 40%.
That's what it. Yeah, I totally forget why they leave all this. That's it. It's an accounting thing. Why they cut it and then just leave it here to rot? I think it's partly accounting and partly. I know this sounds a little strange. Their way of replicating Mother Nature, because a lot of trees fall, and one tree that naturally falls, it provides a lot of growth to the forest. So this is some psychotic capitalist thinking that leaving this like this is helping. Mm-hmm. It's psychotic, and I don't know what the percentage is, but I also know this is a paper accounting thing, but it's all insane.
Yeah.
But I forget the exact reason why they leave so much of this. Like we passed that other area with all birch, and you were talking about earlier how Talk about your culture and what you make with birch.
Yeah, birch, we make a lot of canoe. We make a small canoe. We make teepee, like wigwam. If we don't have nothing, that's what we do. We just get our birch and make canoe, like we make a big wigwam out of it, and make teepee out of it. And we make a lot of things out of it, like a basket, small canoe. And yeah, we make pretty much big basket and everything that we do there. And we get the spruce, some spruce tree. This is where we get the roots to make our basket and our teepee, or when we go, we sew that together. And then we sew it, we put the counter. I think that's a spruce gum or the other kind. What do you call that? Jack pine gum. Yeah. Anyways, we close that in there to not to get cold, just to block the area, not to get the cold. This is what we do about the. When we make a canoe, we use our gum, nature gum, that black gum. We use all that we get all premier gum in jack pine. Then we boil it. Then where they sown, this is where we put all the gums all over,
on the seams, yeah.
Yeah, not to get the water in there. That's, then we try it. If it's good, then we start paddling it. That's what we do. That's what we wanted to teach our kids to do. Not to forget how to make the canoe, to make the wigwam. And how we do the... To make wigwam, we know we have some light window. Long time ago, my mom was explaining me how they do it. They just didn't cover out the window. They used to kill the moose, and the moose guts, they scraped that. And they put it around, just like to make a window. This is where they see the light. And they put that all over. They make it really, really small, and when they kill moose, that's what they do. They share the meat too, but they keep that just to see the light. That's what they used to do. But they don't kill moose for nothing, just to have their guts. It's the only thing they want to use. They share the meat too, and everything that they had. The moose feed there when you the legs. They cut it there, and that's what they used to use the winter boots. And that thing is really so gone, and the water doesn't come in. They're really good for the winter. And what they used to have is to warm their feet, they used to have a rabbit fur. That's what they used to have to warm their feet. And the blanket that they used to use is a rabbit fur. They made that like when you make a fishnet. That's how they make it too. Mm-hmm. They make it bigger, so that's how they make their blanket a long time ago. And they make a bear, that's what they put it on their ground. Everything that they do, sometimes they make some moosehide, and they put the brush under there, and they put the moosehide in there. They tie it. They don't take off the fur, cause just to keep it warm. And they put on top is a bear skin. this whole day is to get warm a long time ago. Before this rags. I mean, this whole day is to get warm.
Shelley? Mm-hmm. Yeah. You want to remind people which territory you're from? Northern Quebec.
Yes, Kitigan-Zibi in northern Quebec. This is my other grandma over here.
Kokom
Liza. Kokom Shelley. Lost for words again. There's no explanation for this kind of destruction. Why would people want to do that? It's just sad to look around and see all this going to waste. It's really, 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 really. I just don't know what to say anymore.
So all we could do is watch, look at it now. Everything is pretty much done here. They got what they want. And what are we gonna have?
Follow those roads, you'll see all the clear cut areas. There's one over there.
Mm-hmm.
Earth is not the same either. There's oil coming up, like there's all that oily water.
Mm-hmm.
There's tiny bit on the other side of the water. There's oil and real water.
two lone trees.
Protect Mother Earth for everyone. Everyone, please take care of her. She is taking care of us. She gave us so much. And man is slowly destroying it. At the beginning, now they're going into it. Whereas if there's no time left. Working day and night to destroy. Everyone.
My name is Dee Shanger. I'm a mod and live stream director here at Occupy Toronto live stream since day one on October 15th, 2011. Yeah, this is pretty sick. And as Kokoms Eliza said, like, what's next here? I mean, clear cutting enough times in this day and age. Because it builds logging roads, access roads, clear cut, that is mining next. Who knows? They're very secretive, very destructive. Yar. Ciao, folks.